Greetings to all. In this video, we are going to start our new chapter, that is lesson 3, Animal Fibers. Before we go through the topic, animal fibers, let us try to understand the meaning of the word fiber. My dear students, fibers are long, strong and flexible thread-like structures that are used to make fabrics. Remember students, fibers are the threads which are used to make long and continuous usable threads called yarns, and these yarns are then woven into fabrics which are used to make stitched clothes for us. Fibers are divided into two categories, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Natural fibers are obtained from natural sources such as plants and animals. Cotton and jute are examples of plant fibers. Remember student, plant fiber consists of a structural material called cellulose. Wool and silk are examples of animal fibers. They are made up of proteins. On the other hand, synthetic fibers are made by human beings using chemicals. It means they are man-made fibers. Polyester, nylon, and acrylic are the examples of synthetic fibers. My dear students, about plant fibers, you have already studied in class 6. So let us discuss about animal fibers in detail. First, we will talk about wool. Wool is an animal fiber obtained from the fur or hair of certain animals like sheep, camel, goat, yak, etc. And this thick coat of fur or hair is called fleece. Now the question arises, why do we use wool? As you know that we wear sweaters, shawls, caps, etc. in winter season because they are made up of wool and keep our body warm. Now our next question is, how does wool keeps our body warm? Wool fiber is porous, means it has lots of air spaces, or we can say air gets trapped in space between the wool fibers. Since air is a bad conductor of heat, so it doesn't allow the body heat to escape and keeps the body warm. Because of this reason, woolen clothes are worn in winters. That's all in this video. Thank you.